What is going on, my drip drops? Dropper here, and welcome back to the channel. You know, another Call of Duty video, chilling and doing the thing. Let me know down in the comment section how you guys' day going. Let me know where you guys are watching the videos from. I'm gonna start asking on my videos, cause I'm really curious about where you guys are watching my videos from. But as you guys can see, we are back. I say with the OG boy, the gun that the sniper that carried me through almost the entire life cycle of MWR. The go-to sniper I love. The go-to sniper I grind for when this game first came out. The go-to sniper that I hit most of my clips with. The Barrett 50 cal. Sorry I'm lagging a little bit. I just don't know why. Like I said, I got shit in it. But welcome back, Barrett. And as you can see, I got this clean weapon kit on this bad boy. Look at that Barrett. It looks so nice. And my shot is good with it. Man, this Barrett looks so sexy. It's so clean. Look at it. This Barrett looks so much better than without this kit. I'm gonna start rocking this Barrett again. The Barrett's got me through a lot. I've been through a lot with this Barrett. If you guys don't know, I've been using the S-Tag. I think everybody really been using the S-Tag, really, because the S-Tag is such a good gun. It's so good. It's like, how can you put that gun and get down? But enough of that. We are back. Overgrown. Not really. It's a good map. It's an okay map. I like it because I snipe, so I got a good view over everything, really. But other than that, this map is really not that good in other situations, like when you have campers. But I'm not gonna go into that situation because you guys know I can ramble on about campers for hours and hours on end. And I know you guys don't want to hear me rant about campers because you guys probably experience it yourself if you play NWR or any other Call of Duty game at that fact. I caught an airstrike and only destroyed a claymore. What's the odds of only hitting the claymore in an airstrike? Like, only hit. Okay, where is he at? Okay, he's behind me. I don't know the way he's playing at, but I'll deal with it. But as you guys can see, I'm playing Call of Duty again. Like, if you guys didn't see the video from, I think, 2 days ago, I honestly, when I upload these videos, they just are in the archive of videos on my channel. I forget when I uploaded it. I could tell you what it was about, because sometimes, like, I really know, like, what I'm talking about in my videos. Sometimes I don't. I just ramble on, but really, I got a good memory of what I talked about in some of my videos, especially if it's a video that I had fun, like, playing and putting together and editing and just uploading it. I could just remember it, like, in a heartbeat. Is that an enemy? That gotta be a teammate. Yes, teammate. I hate when they don't show, like, the blue light over their head. I mean, the blue name, because I'd be wasting so much ammo. But yeah, if you guys didn't see that video, a recent video, playing Call of Duty again. I know some people like Call of Duty, some people like Dragon Ball, some people like both. And if you guys like both, just like me, well, welcome to the family. Well, you're part of the family. But just even more love to you, because if you guys share the same passion I love playing video games with, like, playing video games and Dragon Ball Z and Call of Duty, then I got open arms. I got open arms for you. I just love these two. But I'm not gonna get into that. Like I said, if you guys haven't seen, I think it was What Call of Duty Again, or What Call of Duty. It was something like What Call of Duty. If you guys haven't seen that video, I'll go check it out, because I wouldn't say there'll be a link down in the description, because I might forget. Because sometimes putting these videos together, you just forget the littlest things like that, or putting cards in your videos or something. But that's really the YouTuber life. You're gonna forget some things. Hell, even if you're not a YouTuber, you're gonna forget things, like little things. Hell, like forgetting to cut the grass sometimes. I don't know, but we all forget. It's human nature. We are all not perfect. I'm not perfect, at least. But we're all not perfect. Excuse me. Recently I've been coughing lately in my videos. I don't know why. I think it's because my throat began dry from doing all these videos. I'm ready to grind. Because I've been grinding Dokkan Battle, but I'm ready to grind more than Dokkan Battle. And which is gonna be World War II. But I'm not gonna make any, I don't know. It'd probably be different this year. Because I remember when this game first came out, I was like, oh, I'm about to grind this game. This game about to be, I'm about to get to Prestige Master level 1000. Yeah, that's not happening anymore. I don't know where my passion and the beloved went. It just vanished. I don't know what happened to it. I think, and you guys probably are in the same boat as I am with this one. If you guys not, then let me know the reason why you guys, we don't play this game as much. But the reason why I really don't play this game as much is because I played it so much back in the day when it was in its prime. Call of Duty 4 back in the day was a spot to be. I had it on PS3. So I grind this game out with my brother all day, every day. Search and Destroy, Team Deathmatch, I think Headquarters, and then a little bit of Domination. Grind this game out every day, all day. From the time I wake up to the time I go to sleep. The only breaks I would take is to get something to eat, something to drink, or use the bathroom. That's the only break I would take. But other than that, I grind this game so much back in the day. It's just really grinding this game now. It's fun, but it's just the good memories and the bad memories are coming back to this game that I remember having back in the day. So that's why I really haven't been grinding this game. I'm only like 5th prestige. If I really wanted to grind this game, I could be like legitimately like 10th prestige right now. Like if I really, like if I, hear me out. If I really, really, really wanted to be level 1,000, I probably could be level 1,000 right now. Cause I probably do more than, majority of my ranking will be sniping, but I'll probably throw some red gun in there, here and there. Cause red gun in this game is fun too. Like, really playing this game is fun, especially if you partying up at least one other person or more than one person. But other than that, I don't know. I don't know where my passion went. Like, I had so much passion for this game, and then it just disappeared. But like I just said, it's probably just because I played this game so much in the past that I'm tired of it already. Excuse me again. But World War II would probably be a different story. Because I haven't played World War II yet. And it's back to World War II. And it's a different game. It's not futuristic. It's not this flying in the sky and wall running, which, don't get me wrong, I enjoyed it for Black Ops 3, but Infinite Warfare, I just kind of, I'd rather play Black Ops 3 if I want to fly around and run on walls and embarrass people with crazy-ass shots with snipers from flying around the wall. But I just don't want to play Infinite Warfare, and I really don't play going back to Black Ops 3 anymore. I'm just so tired of the futuristic setting. And like I said, you guys are probably in the same boat I am. Like, a lot of you guys watching this are probably almost in the same boat I am. Just, you guys are tired of the future. You guys want to go back to regular boots on the ground, flank routes, good maps, and all. Well, don't get me wrong, Black Ops 3 don't have good maps, don't get me wrong. Like, the new Call of Duty got good maps, but I'm ready to go back to, like, the old maps where you gotta flank. Because, like, the newer maps are just, like, close quarter battle. That's it. But the older maps, like, the older Call of Duty games, like, the maps are, like, it's always that one. You guys, it's so funny because the older Call of Duty games, I just think about this. I have so many memories just come back in my head of the old Call of Duty games. Like, you guys know on Nuketown, the old Nuketown, like Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, even Black Ops 3, the middle of the map is the hot. I'm trying to think of some maps off the top of my raid. The little middle part where the pond, not the fountain, but the other middle part, like where you go, like when you go down the stairs, it's like the pool and all that. I should say the middle of the map. That was the middle of the map, I think. That was the hot spot of the map. Like, if you wasn't right there, then you probably wasn't getting that much kills. Unless you was like a god and you was moving around the map, like, non-stop. But that's where all the firefights are happening. So it's like, that's what I'm trying to say. The newer ones are always like close quarters. Like, the fights are everywhere. The fights are all over the map. The older Call of Duty games, there's always that one spot of the map where it's just everybody will meet up. Snipers, SMGs, assault rifles, even pistols will meet up in that spot and start going crazy. What? I hate claymores! I hate them so much! There's nothing more annoying than getting but killed by a claymore. A little device that just sit there and kills anybody that just got caught slipping. But yeah, that's the video of the day. And like I said, this is another normal Call of Duty video. I just talk to you guys and just chill out. And talk, like I said, talk what's on my mind. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like. And if you guys really, 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 really enjoyed the video, consider hitting that subscribe button. Yeah, it's been Dropper, guys. See you guys later.